Hey bada bada bada, hey bada bada bada, a swing bada. Hey guys, this is the Predictors Podcast, number 46, and I'm your co-host, KFD3D, the legendary predictor. And I mean legendary predictor. And I'm with my partner in crime, Tony Rendy.
Man, gotta get on that amiibo crack, all you motherfuckers out there. We gotta fight for it, like hobos on the street.
That's right, man. Like, you want amiibo, you gotta work for it, man. You know, that's the struggle to collect them all, you know. You guys, now all you guys know how Ash Ketchum felt, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you see, he's like, he still has to catch them all, you know, nearly what, 15 years later. Goddamn,
sucks.
He's confined to the age of 10.
Mm-hmm.
Forever. But anyway, I digress.
No, I got no space for this shit.
Yo, what are you trying to download? Yeah.
Try to get that Liberation Maiden.
That's right.
$299.
That's a good segue for the first topic, and that is Nintendo eShop price drop deals. And Nintendo eShop is having some sweet ass deals across both platforms, the Wii U and the 3DS. And you guys have to capitalize on it, man. If you want that indie love, if you want that, this, well, majority is indie love, you know, but yeah, indie love, then you came to the right place. And that's Nintendo eShop on either 3DS or the Wii U. At the, you know, that holiday cheer is upon us with all these great deals. And for me personally, I picked up Shantae and the Pirate's Curse. It wasn't on special, but you know, that game is an awesome game. It just came out on the Wii U on the Christmas Day, right?
Yeah.
And the 3DS version came out a couple of weeks back. But not too long ago.
Mm-hmm.
And that game is for like $19.99 US. But if you're in Canada, it's $22.23.
The fuck?
because they did the conversion, you know. They didn't say
random ass number. They didn't even like round it up or down or anything.
Yeah, you know. They just give us the conversion.
The 23 cents slap in the face.
Yeah. But at the end of the day, we get more credit for when we buy it towards the Digital Deluxe promotion.
Better hurry the fuck up.
Because the deadline is up January 31st.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to, that's the deadline. So you better make your purchases quick. Another game I picked up was Master Reboot. And that game is for $5.99.
Wait. For Shantae, did you play it on your Wii U or?
Yeah. But I'm gonna get to that.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, another game I bought was Master Reboot, $5.99. And like Tony was saying, you know, I picked up Liberation Maiden. That's the reason why he's buying it right now.
Mm-hmm.
And I bought that for $2.99. And what did you pick up, Tony, for the Wii U?
I picked up DuckTales Remastered by WayForward.
Yeah, and it's like, what, around $6 or something like that, Canadian?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the same price for the U.S. I don't know, but it's about that, around that price, maybe a little bit less.
Mm-hmm.
Because the WayForward seems to be doing the conversion for us, man. I don't know why. But, like, why are you doing this to us, WayForward? Why? You just can't, you gotta get every cent from us, do you? You know what I mean? Yeah. But it's all right, man, whatever. Anyway, yes, I did play, I'm playing Shantae and the Pirate's Curse right now, and as you people saw, you know, you see my posts on Miiverse, people who follow me on Miiverse or who are friends with me on the Wii U.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've been playing Shantae, and my god, that game is a fun ass game. You know, it's like, it plays like Metroid, it plays like Zelda, and it plays like your, you know, like your typical action RPG. Yeah, it's a really cool game, and it has like a bunch of this awesome characters and characters full of life and kind of quirky in a bit, in a way. And there's kind of like in the level, there's like side quests you could do and stuff like that. It's kind of similar to how Zelda works in that way. It's a really cool game. It's really fun. And it's very funny. It's a funny game at times. It's very comical. There's a part of the game where, man, I swear, yeah, I'm not gonna give all the details, but like, yeah, she killed that dude. Yeah, Shantae, she killed that dude. Man. Yeah, that's messed up, man. I'll let you find out all the details when you play it yourself. But yeah, that's a game you guys need to pick up, Shantae and the Pirate's Curse. I really gotta get into the other games because this is my first game, and I can honestly see like there's like it's not like, really a big deal, but like there's a story, okay? Like you can see like they kind of give some hints to what happened in the previous game and stuff. So it's like yeah, it really is a sequel. It really has like a story to it. It almost feels like a animated cartoon almost how the story is, you know?
That's cool.
It's cool though. It's a really cool game.
How does it look on the Wii U? Does it look like just a handheld game up-res'd or
Yeah. This is a handheld game with upgrades. That's it. You know, no 3D. This HD resolution. Same thing like My Switch Force 2 on the Wii U. Same shit. But that's okay. They're coming with the other Shantae game, the Kickstarter game they made. They're working on for the Wii U. So that's gonna have all the hand-drawn stuff, you know, so it's all right. Yeah, you know, and that's it. How about DuckTales? I heard you play DuckTales. How's the game
I've
so far?
been wanting this game for a long time. DuckTales. Fucking love DuckTales. I don't like the DuckTales on YouTube, if you know what I mean. Quack, quack.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, this is the only DuckTales we're gonna talk about. This, you
Yeah,
know,
exactly.
it's only,
DuckTales
the only the.
Remastered.
Yeah.
It's a different game to the NES game, and I feel that people kind of shit on it unnecessarily, just from playing just a couple levels here and there.
Yeah.
Because they always complained about it stopping and always talking and shit like that. But I don't mind the new story because it's like a brand new episode of the show, DuckTales.
Yeah, sure, because that makes sense when you say it like that. Because if you're basing off like a TV show, you know, you probably, if you're a fan of the TV show, you probably don't mind the whole those type of stops,
Yeah,
you
because
know.
the voice actors are all the same.
Yeah.
So you hear fucking Huey, Dewey, and Louie, they sound the same. Scrooge McDuck sounds the same. I just like hearing it. Yeah, the game is easier. Like you actually know where to go now, and
I mean,
there's a quick.
what else is not easy? What else is not easier, you know,
Exactly.
these days, you
But
know?
man, I don't mind it. It's good. It looks beautiful. Animation's nice. The music is great, as always. It's even better. Updated, you know. So yeah, I got no issues with this game so far.
That sounds good. That's good. That's good. DuckTales. Woo! I'm telling you, that's a catchy ass theme song. Yeah. I'm saying.
Course, you know it.
Yeah.
What's that master reboot you're talking about?
Massive Reboot is like, I didn't play it yet, but it's like an indie game by Wales Interactive, I think. And it's basically like a first-person shooter. I think adventure, survival horror. I think it's survival horror. I don't know. The game is so cool to me. And when I read this description, I'm saying, you know what? I want to play this game. And I think when I see the game first, it's not from what's that dude name? From Nintendo Enthusiasts. What's Sean Long. Yeah, Sean Long. Like, he had it in one of his videos, and the game looked kind of appealing to me, man. Something that I would like, you know, like type of those, you know, some of those like those PC indie game type of stuff. Like,
yeah,
yeah, you know, look kind of cool. So I said, you know, let me try it out. You know, have these creepy looking girls. I don't know. It's like basically your soul is uploaded to some computer.
Okay.
Some shit like that. That's what I read in the synopsis and in the description. And I guess you have to survive. I don't know, man. I'll have to play the game to really give you details. But
yeah.
Yeah, it looks cool. It looks cool. You know, Liberation Maiden, I think most people know what that's about. You know, you're president of New Japan. Yeah, I was watching the trailer before I bought the game.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you, that trailer is fucking jokes, man. Like, Japanese are freaking crazy, man. It's the most weirdest shit. Like, where you even get the idea for this shit? Like,
yeah.
And you see these dudes, man. The votes are in, man. And then hey, you have the gun, the mecha there. And she's launching.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, and the guys, they're like, Godspeed. I was laughing, yo. Like, this is so stupid, man. This is craziness, man. You gotta love them, man. But anyway, let's move on to the next topic.
Mm-hmm.
And we're gonna talk about games that are coming out 2015. Because if you thought 2014 was fire, just wait for 2015, man. We got hell more to come, you know? Hell more to come.
Oh, we didn't add one game.
Yeah, don't worry. I'll add that one. Yeah, don't worry. Right. Remember it, man. Remember it.
Mm.
But anyway, the first game we'll talk about was coming out February of 2015, and that is Kirby and the Rainbow Curse.
Mm-hmm.
And that game is that game. You know, recently we just got the news about the Amiibo compatibility.
Yeah.
But, you know, that shit gonna be useless because we're not gonna find none of these shit at Story, yo, man. You know, we got these crack feeds, yo. We buy everything, man. Have them closed up, not even using them. You motherfuckers.
Hey, let me just say, man, with those Amiibos, I told you, the last Particulars podcast, I told everybody, you gotta have the Eye of the Tiger. Fucking no, because I warned all of you, there's gonna be lots of competition. And hey, man, it's fucking crazy. You gotta have the dedication, you gotta have the craziness. If you want to collect these things, if you need these things, you gotta put in the work. You gotta be up fucking early, you gotta wait at the doors.
Mm.
You know what I mean? You gotta have a friend in the back room, me. My friend fucking loves me because I tell him, hey, we just got this shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you stop, boy.
I'm telling you, man. Like, you gotta have that inside connections and shit. All that sort of damn things, man. You gotta call every day. You gotta be there every day. You gotta go multiple stores. Maybe on the off chance, maybe you'll have it out of nowhere. You never know. But you got to do it. You can't just sit there and bitch. Yes, it's too bad that these stocks are very low.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard from a Nintendo rep when I was at Walmart looking for shit. That same day they got the shipment for Little Mac and fucking Zelda and mm-hmm. Diddy, right? They got that shipping in. Everybody was gone except for Zelda.
Yo, okay, Boxing Day. I went to Target. I tried to capitalize on that damn Wiimote, okay? I didn't get shit, man. But yeah, that's besides the point. I saw the Amiibo, yo. All I saw was two Marios and two Peaches.
Oh, shit.
Yo, man, I'm telling you, these motherfuckers would be great. Yo, I'm telling you, even if they had a bigger stock, you still want to be able to get this shit,
yeah,
man.
Yeah,
these people are crazy, man. Like, I'm telling you. You like, when you see shit like that, you know this shit is the real deal, man. You gotta be there or you're not gonna get shit, okay? Yeah. But I know, I assure you, there's a lot of people out there wanting Amiibo right now. Just to hide them, I don't think Nintendo, even if they had a bigger stock coming, they wouldn't even could even even that would be enough to keep up with the demand. I really believe that, man, because the way these things are selling out in minutes.
Yeah.
Like, every day is Boxing Day for these shits.
It is minutes. It's true.
Like, what the fuck? Yo, that's crazy. These motherfuckers need to calm their shit, man. Exactly. Yo, man, you guys are going crazy, man. People be...
Plus...
swiping this shit.
I don't know whose fault it is, but the stores themselves, they're getting... they're not... there's no street date, especially for Wave 2. There's no street date.
Mm-hmm.
So, we had the first three figures come out 3 weeks ago, and the next three figures, Luigi, Captain Falcon, and fucking Pit.
Yeah.
Some stores had it last week. Some stores had it this week. Some stores had it the week before that. You know, there is no set street date. I don't know whose fault that is. When I was talking to that rep, the Nintendo rep, he said that there was a shipment problem in Canada. Because okay. It seems to me, in the U.S., from what the pictures that Joe Cidion put up,
yeah,
they have more shit there, like at his store.
Yeah, okay.
So I don't even fucking know the availability on the East Coast or in Canada or U.S., whatever. It might just be all over the place, right?
Well, also that he lives in a very small community, right? Like a town or like
yeah,
the suburbs, whatever. So I don't know if it's just that, and because, you know, we... like, me and you, we live in major cities, okay? Like, Montreal and Toronto, so maybe it's that. Like, maybe it's the same shit in New York City, you know, for example, or, like, yeah. Chicago and stuff. Like, dumb things that be, or, like, Boston. Dumb people be wiping that shit, man. I'm telling you, all these people are crack fiends, man.
You gotta get on it, man.
Crack fiends, man.
When I see that, well, the other day,
yesterday,
yeah. When I saw that shit, the cart come up from the elevator, from receiving.
Yeah.
They were wheeling that shit in, and I saw a whole fucking stack of amiibos. And I saw Captain Falcon. I fucking raided that cart. It didn't even get out to the damn floor yet. And I already took two for myself.
Wow.
I took Pit, and I took Captain Falcon. Today, the rest went out. And already there's only one Pit. Actually, there was no Pits because my other friend in the back room took it too. So there's no Pits.
Oh, man.
Just three Captain Falcons left and Luigi's.
And I'm also hearing that even with the low shipment, these things are outselling fucking the other ones.
Skylanders
and the... what's it called? Disney Infinity. So I wonder if that if just an issue with the toy industry now is like they're not retailers not taking big shipments anymore. You know? Man.
Skylanders, we have a shit ton.
You got a shit ton? Okay.
Shit ton of Skylanders, a shit ton of fucking Infinity.
And but people are not buying it like that though.
Yeah, but for Infinity, for Amiibos to actually do that kind of business,
yeah,
that's pretty damn good for just the figures.
Yeah.
Because for Skylanders and fucking Infinity, you got the sets for every system. You got the characters. You got the bundle packs of three and whatever.
Oh, yeah. They have, like, a lot of different, like, bundles and shit. They have more, like, they sell it in various ways, like, you know, so they could get it around to people.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that makes sense for that because you really need them. You know, like, you really need them to play those fucking games. So it makes sense for that product. Amiibo, you don't really need an amiibo. Like,
these aren't necessary. And not, like, in this Kirby game, is just like what they do. It's not necessary there either. But
yeah, it's just you know, extra incentive to your game. You know.
Mm-hmm. And let me just say, if you want that Meta Knight, what's Meta Knight exclusive to? What store? I forget. It's not Toys R Us.
Toys R Us.
No.
Best Buy.
Your ass better fucking be on that Best Buy website and pre-ordering. If not, you better go to the fucking store early.
But I wonder if
you will scalp.
I wonder if they're gonna reship them though, like these amiibos for when this game comes out. Kirby's.
Kirby's, they're always going to have Kirby's. Actually, I don't know. I haven't seen a replenishment of Kirby's for a while. I see a whole bunch of Mario's, I see a whole bunch of Yoshis. Samus, we still got some. Like,
it seems like Mario and the Peach is the easy ones to get, right?
Yeah, they, so keep,
like
every... they keep bringing Pikachus back, too. The, every shipment, we have a couple Marios and Pikachus and Peaches and shit like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
But for everybody else, like, for instance, Martha, I never seen in my life. But we have...
Yeah, what do you say? I don't see that motherfucker.
We have a peg. We have a peg hook, right?
Okay.
On the floor called Marth. But... Okay. When I got Pit, when he scans on the computer, it comes up as Marth.
Okay.
So that might mean, yo, that takes over. Whatever's the most rare, that's going to be called the Marth estate. It's true. It's true, though. That's what I'm thinking right now.
Yo, that takes over, man.
Yeah.
That's funny, yo. Pit, man. Now he's the new Mark.
Yeah, he's the new Mark.
Yo, that's funny, man.
So, hey, get on that Pit, motherfuckers. I'm telling you.
That's what I'm saying. I got to pre-order that Sheik. I got to pre-order that my Toon Link. Because I know you crack fiends. I go crazy for that, too. I got to stop. I got to be there on that, man. Because you guys are crazy.
Yeah.
But anyway, let's talk about how these... how these three amiibos work with this game. Now, according to this, to the, you know, to the news and everything, King DDD's amiibo, and, you know, it basically boosts Kirby's defense, and I guess it allows Kirby to take more damage than usual.
Yeah, and he wears a hat.
And he wears, basically wears King DDD's hat. That's pretty fucking cool. Okay, Meta Knight basically unlocks a... You know, you get a Meta Knight mask, and it boosts Kirby's attack power. So, and Kirby amiibo, what does that do? Allows in the game Kirby to use the Star Dash ability an unlimited number of times.
So, yeah.
So, what the fuck is a Star Dash ability? I guess that's an ability in the game.
Yeah.
So if you have the Kirby amiibo, if you have all these amiibo, give yourself a golf clap. Pat yourself on the back. Yeah, because
they come out in February.
Hey, because
get on that shit. I'm telling you,
man.
I will.
Meta Knight. Yo, these people are crazy, man. People are nuts. Yeah, okay, let's move on to the next game.
Yeah.
Devil's Third.
Excited for this.
Yeah, this game is going to be badass. And this recent news from Itagaki, he's basically said that he talked more about the game, and he basically said, you know, can't wait to... deliver the game for next year for you, for us, you know, and all that. Hold on, sorry, man. I'm trying to fucking...
What?
Yeah, I'm trying to open this damn link. Yeah. And, yeah, and he also, you know, he said all that. And you know what surprised me about this? That this game actually, he spent 6 years on this game, working on this game. 2 years of conceptualizing. 2 years of this thinking about this game and how it could work.
I know.
Like, what the fuck?
That's rare.
That's very rare, man. I never, wow. But I could see why, because it was kind of, it's really ambitious goal to make a hack and slash first person shooter. Like, that's never been done before. Like, wow, like that's really crazy. Like, you see that innovation, man. Itagaki, the G over here, the boss, showing these thoughts, these third party thoughts, how it's done. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying, how it's done. And basically 4 years of actual development. That's crazy.
Which switched consoles,
though. Yeah, with Switch consoles too, but it probably could have took a little bit less than that. But still, the actual, you know, to have actual 2 years of conceptualizing, that's crazy. Wow. And yeah, this game is really cool. The characters look cool. It kind of reminds me of, well, I guess not to that level, but like normal heroes.
Yeah.
The diversity of the characters and the
Yeah, I guess.
bosses kind of reminds me to a little bit of that from the small tips we've, well, the small footage we have seen of the game. It looks cool and it looks like it has an interesting story. You have the girl sniper, and she used to be, she knew him from a child or something. I guess now they're enemies, or it seemed like that. We'll see how that goes.
Dun, dun, dun.
The bitch gonna get slayed.
Yeah. Cut her ass up.
That's right. In the bed. Haha, I don't know, I'm just playing.
Well, definitely this is going to be a good action game. He knows, Igaki knows what he's doing, so.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing. Looks fantastic.
There'll be lots of blood and
Lots
guts
of blood, lots of
cutting
blood.
and arms flying everywhere.
Yeah, it's cool that he's taking his time to work on the game to get it done. Nintendo, those Nintendo reps, supervisors, like, hey, you better not fuck up, huh? Our name is on the box.
Yeah.
I like when Nintendo, yo, when they ever helping these dudes make a game, they make sure you don't fuck up, And I find that game always comes out, like, you can always be like, you don't have to worry about that game because Nintendo is there helping them, supervising, and it's like, Nintendo's no bullshit. They want a good product, okay? You don't fuck up, no nonsense, just do the best you can, you know what I mean? If you gotta delay that shit, don't worry, we're paying the check. So don't worry about that. I mean, we've seen the results for Bayonetta 2. I won't even put it past them that we've seen the results in 104-101, et cetera, et cetera. And we'll see the results further in Devil's Third. And just to talk about Devil's Third, we actually have two actually unannounced games that was rumored to be announced.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, like two or three or something like that. And there was a rumor. So, man, I'm telling you, for next year, that Nintendo Direct, don't be surprised. You be busting them bombs, yo. Out of Nintendo Direct or E3, whatever the case might be.
Oh shit.
You know?
Can't handle
I
it.
was saying, man, he's like, oh, wow, he keeps coming with those bomber bombs, man. Gun blazing. But yes, talk about the next game. And
Okay.
that's Yoshi's Woolly World. Now let's talk about this game. It's Yoshi with yarn. The end.
As usual, we are.
That's it. No, I don't know. Last time we saw it was like, what, E3?
Yeah, I think so. I think
Yeah,
that was
E3. Something like that. And they said the game. Sorry. They said the game is coming out in the first half of 2015 still, so it's not delayed. Thank God. So I wonder what's taking them so long. Why we haven't seen new footage of this game? No, I'm
Yeah.
joking, but I don't really care about that. Like, I know they're gonna
Fuck
show
me. You're fucking up.
it. I don't really care about that. I mean, I know they're gonna show it, and they're gonna show it when they're ready to show it. But like, yeah, the game looked cool from the last time we saw it. It has a lot of interesting yarn gameplay mechanics. It's like, step up from Kirby's Epic Yarn. Yeah, I don't know. What else you have to say about this game, Tony?
Another one of those so cute, like fucking die games. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
It's like everything's fucking all bouncy and and
you got the yarn lion or whatever.
yeah.
I don't know, man. It's like when
That
they're
line, it's a dog. I
it's a
don't even
lion, it's a lion, a dog, a lion dog, whatever,
doesn't
man.
matter. It's
Doesn't
fucking cute.
matter.
Kill it.
That's what I'm saying, man. One of these games, man, is just, you just want to kill that motherfucker. Like,
Yeah.
You have the urge to kill him, though. Like, it's like, oh, I gotta die.
I wonder if they're gonna make it possible for Yoshi to die in this game, so people don't bitch like Kirby. Epic Yarn. Can't die in this game.
I think he could die, though. I think he can die. I assume that he could die because of the... Wasn't it like an animation where he turns into like yarn strips or some shit like that?
Yeah.
I think so. Like he just, you know, he just poofs. Yep. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, so I think he could die. It's basically like Yoshi Island, but a different twist on it, on the game. Uh-huh. You know, which is cool. I was going to have Amiibo support too. So,
Oh, I wonder which one.
Yoshi.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That one's easy to find, motherfuckers. Don't worry about that one.
That one's easy to find? All right. I was about to say, that shit gonna be useless too, yeah. Uh-huh. You can't find it. You can't find it, man. Those Amiibos, man. You can't find them. So, yeah. That's Yoshi's Wally World coming out next year. Next game. The game that we've all been waiting for. The game that we all want to play. The game that's going to rock our world. You know, take away our lives. Make us quit our jobs and all that shit. And that's Xenoblade Chronicles X.
Goddamn.
That Gundam X.
Yeah, Gundam
X. That Gundam Blade X.
Shit. Game's gonna be crazy, man.
The game's fucking crazy.
Don't need to beat the other one. Son of a bitch. Because of fucking work, holiday bullshit. I got no time. And when I do have time, I want to sleep.
That's the thing, yo. It's like, when you have some of these hobbies, man, it's hard to balance them. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes it's like, what is going to get sacrificed?
Something's got to go. It's all right.
That's right.
What are you doing?
Right.
We're getting distracted. What's wrong with you?
Sorry about that. But anyway, like I was talking about, Xenoblade Chronicles X. You know, we got some good information about this game from the director of the game.
Yeah.
A lot of anime industry bigs working on this game. Like, they got the graphic designer, artist for, like, from, like, Gundam.
Obviously.
Gundam. I think it was Gundam 00, I heard.
It looks like Gundam 00.
I think I heard with Gundam 00.
As long as it doesn't look like Gundam No Gigunista or whatever the fuck.
Oh my god. Oh man, yo, that anime, man. Why you have to bring that up right now, man? Like, seriously, man.
I forget what. Joe said something on Twitter or something about it.
Oh yeah, he said, Turn Gundam on crack.
Yeah, not the good kind of crack.
Yeah, that's the bad.
Want to mess you up. Mess up the face, all scrunched up and shit. I guess that's what happened to that Gundam. Oh, fuck.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Yeah, like I was saying. I heard that they also have the sound composer, fucking my man, what's his name?
Some Japanese dude.
Yeah, but anyway, he's the dude who did fucking all these animes I watch, man. Guilty Crown, Kill a Kill, you know, people, you know, that Attack on Titan, Shingeki no Kojin, fucking Anoa Zero, Even the new one that hit, fucking the Seven Deadly Sins. Nah, I forgot the Japanese for it, but the Japanese.
Nanatsu or
something. Yeah, some shit like that. Nanatsu. And, yeah, this man is a motherfucking beast, people. Mm-hmm. He knows how to compose. Like, he has, like, his music makes you, man, get up off your seat and just boom. It makes your heart start pumping, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, when those epic moments happen, when, like, I don't know, anime, people who watch anime, you know when the character does that epic shit?
Yeah, okay? Exactly,
Yo, his music make you get off your seat,
bro. Some epic shit or some fucking crazy-ass drama happen. Like, you know that in the first episode of Attack on Titan?
Yeah.
Where the Titan's just going up to his mom and just gonna eat her and shit, and the music just comes on, like, oh, what's
happening? That's what I'm saying, yo. He has that music. Same thing. People watch Kill la Kill. That music, yo. You know what I'm saying, man? Like, he has that epic music that makes your heart psh, psh.
Yeah.
You get off your seat, man. It's like,
Speaking of that, I don't know if people know, but the full version of the E3 trailer, the music is finally up on YouTube. So
yeah, you could download it. Yeah,
download it or fucking go search it out. You know how long we've been looking for this fucking music?
Oh, this is insane. I downloaded it too, and yo, that shit right there, man. Like, It has like this part where like it's like Chinese drums or whatever. It's like, yeah. You know what I'm saying, man? It feels like, well, that's not like, yo, this man is a genius, man. Mm-hmm. You know, he makes some good music, man. He's the best in the anime industry right now, man. The best music composer in the anime industry is this man right there. Hiroyuki Sawano.
There you go.
That's his name, man. He's the shit right now in the anime industry. And the fact that fucking Monolith Soft got him for this game is amazing, man. Boy, they got all the anime industry bigs to work on this game, which is crazy. You know. Wait, is that the full? Did they have a full version for that one too?
Yeah.
Did that one? That song too? Oh, I thought it was the other one. The other song you were talking about. Oh yeah, sorry, that's not the E3 one. That's the January one. The January direct one.
This one's
E3. That's the E3. Okay. I gotta download that one then. I gotta download that one. See, I was getting mixed up.
Fuck, crazy. Just looking at this picture that they have on here and listening to the music, I'm like,
That's what I'm saying, man. That's what I'm saying. This is going to be a mecha fan's dream right here. This is to play this game. This is Xenoblade X, because it's just like you're in your mecha suit and you just fucking people up and you just flying around just doing badass shit. You're turning a bike and you're just doing, you know, you just
that game is why. Oh, man. This game is why it's going to be like, I always wanted a fucking combo of my anime and my games.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just have the anime craziness with the game craziness, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just, but was it possible? But now it's fucking possible, and it's just making me, like, drool.
I'm telling you, this is why Wii U is the truth, okay? This is the reason why you need to buy a Wii U today if you don't got one. It's shit like this because you got these programmers, you got these designers, you got these developers doing shit on the Wii U that the other two are just not doing.
Nope.
You could argue with me all day with that, but it's just the damn truth. It's the damn truth. And the only reason you disagree with me right now is because it has to do with Nintendo. Yeah. And that's the damn truth. But I digress. Okay, if you guys want to live in your blind world, fucking be in denial that, oh, like, you're not being scammed with DLC and trying to make it seem like Nintendo was scamming us with DLC 2 was not the damn truth, because affordable prices, more for your buck, is not a damn scam.
Mm-hmm.
And you could try to flip that as much as you want, but it's the damn truth. But, you know, living in denial bullshit just because, oh no, don't tell me I'm being scammed by Sony Microsoft. Don't tell me that I'm being scammed by third-party thoughts. Boo, 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 boo. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't tell me that KD. Well, I'm telling you, that's the damn truth. You are.
Mm.
You know.
Fucking crazy.
Fucking crazy. But anyway, I digress with that. This game is going to be a major hit next year. That's Xenoblade Chronicles X. Next game is that Star Fox Wii U.
Mm-hmm.
Star Fox. The game that people complain for, well, the franchise that people wanted a new entry for a long damn time, that they complain,
yeah,
or essays in forums, made rant videos on, fucking wanted Awada to be fired,
mm-hmm,
wanted Miyamoto to be fired,
mm-hmm,
wanted Reggie to be fired,
yeah.
Want everybody to be fired. The whole board to be fired. You know, before, man. We want Star Fox, motherfucker. Like, you know what I'm saying? You know?
Goddamn.
Everybody be fired, man. Like, the game is finally being made and nobody's going to buy it. You know, I'm just playing, yo. You know what I'm saying? I'm just playing, though. But nah, seriously.
That makes me sad, though, man.
Yo, because
I'm over here. I'm over here. I'm all quiet and shit about Star Fox. I love Star Fox. I'm all quiet. I don't fucking bitch. I don't, you know.
You know?
And I'll buy it. But all those people talking the noise and shit like that, they're not going to buy it. And
yo, because I feel, this is insane. Like, I'm going to buy Star Fox. I hear about the tips on the game. The fact that Miyamoto's working on a game intrigues me even more.
Mm-hmm.
But I just have this feeling you're going to have these people who are going to find excuses not to buy it.
Yeah.
When the game is revealed, you're going to look at the game and they're going to tell themselves, oh, the game don't got online multiplayer, so I'm not going to buy it because fuck this game. This game was supposed to have online multiplayer and all this shit and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, exactly.
It was supposed to be like Assault, but even more, and all this and all this mumble jumble, 16-player online.
Goddamn. You
know, it was supposed to play like Starhawk on the PS3 and shit like that. You know what I mean? Getting these wild imaginations for this.
Starhawk. We're calling Starhawk a fucking bitch.
Nah. I'm just thinking. I think that's the imagination for these people. Like, I think that's what they want for Starhawk. I could be going a little overboard with my claims around these people, but I feel that's the type of Starhawk they had in their head, you know? We're reading all the comms they had. It's like basically they want Starhawk, right? That's a game called Starhawk. But Starhawk with Star Fox. That's basically what you want. But no, that's not the game you're going to get. That is definitely not the game you're going to get. You're going to get a Star Fox. Quite frankly, I'm really prepared for this game not even having online. Straight up. I'm prepared. Because quite frankly, I don't even think it needs online. I don't mind it being just a single player game. Just being like Star Fox 64, but like with that extra, you know, butter on top, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I think it's been a while, man. And the way the rate this game is going, it's coming out very early. I thought this game would be like late 2014, but nah, it's coming out before. Well, actually, that doesn't mean anything, yo. And that could be like late 2014, but like 2 days before Zelda came out comes out.
2 days.
Yeah, two days before Zelda comes out. Yeah, yeah, that's when Star Fox coming out. Yo, because he said it's gonna be before Zelda comes out, but that don't mean shit. That could be like a day before, for all we know.
Exactly.
A week before. No, but anyway, like, you know, like, I'm not expecting that much, and that's all I really. And I'm okay with that. I don't really need online and Star Fox and all that shit. I don't mind just having a single player game and you just flying around in the air ring, and you know, you're in the in the R-Wing transforming into all that stuff, into another vehicle. That to me is cool. You know, that sounds cool.
Well, we'll see.
And we'll see though.
Still kind of, we don't have enough information on that game.
Yeah. But personally, this is personally me. Like, I don't really mind, because even though Assault was like a poor game in a way, I still like the concept of like things. So I think if they want to go and incorporate that shit, even though I'm not really expecting that much, if they want to incorporate like those like on the ground missions, I wouldn't mind that, to be honest.
Because please, I feel be better.
But I feel like they could do it better this time. Because it wasn't a bad idea, it was just implemented badly. That was the
yeah.
It's done badly. But it was actually a good idea. You know.
I'd rather them just stick to one thing, get that really good. You know what I mean? Tight. I mean,
and then like think about that for future installments.
Yeah.
Maybe, yeah, you know, but
well, who knows? With the Wii U, they could probably do something. I don't know. Fix that fucking on foot shit. So
yeah. But what I really like is how the game is gonna be using the gamepad. That's really intriguing me about this game, how the game's gonna be played with the gamepad, because Miyamoto has been really talking about it. He's been showing like, you know, showing the motion controls and stuff. And that really intrigues me, how this game could be played with that. And, you know, we heard, like, tips on how the cockpit is going to be on the gamepad.
Yeah.
And maybe you could actually shoot for the gamepad. So that's going to be some crazy shit you're doing with the two screen, with your TV and the gamepad. That's going to be really cool. It might be the ultimate R-Rails shooter.
It should be.
Yeah, it should be. With the gamepad, you know, make it, like, really crazy. If they're going to go down that route, which I think they are. I think it's going to be all, like, a basically on-rail shooter. Nothing more beyond that. But we'll see.
Yeah. Like we said, it's still too fucking early. It's
too fucking early.
Then we got... Splatoon.
Oh, that's the game. Shit, I forgot, y'all. You don't want to say another game, but I forgot Splatoon. You're right. Splatoon. Splatoon. Basically, that's a rumor that in the instrumental song. Mm-hmm. That's basically what they're saying. Splatoon.
Really?
Yeah. But, you know, they you know, made into like a song in a way, you know. So basically, that's what the people were saying in forums and stuff. Like, that actually, they're also saying Splatoon.
Gonna be another crazy ass game.
I mean, another crazy ass game. A freaking hit. Hold on.
What? Wait. This man just dipped. That's alright. So yeah, multiplayer looks crazy on that Splatoon. And the single player, which they showed off recently too. They're going to have some cool ass ideas for some puzzles or platforming shit that you use your ink to get up walls and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's
lots of ideas.
Yeah, and you know, they're gonna have the personally, like, this game to me is let me see how I say this now, how I explain this now. It's an innovative concept, you know. And I know there's gonna be some people, well, not a lot of people, but like a small minority, will be downballing the game and can't understand why, you know. Like, people are excited for this game.
Yeah.
But people need to understand that when you're a video game fan and you're a fan of game design and you're a fan of game mechanics, the look of the game, we don't really give a fuck about that, you know? It's the shit you could do in the game that makes the game fun.
Yeah.
You know? And I could, you know, if this game had, like, instead of ink, it was blood, and it was more, you know, realistic looking characters.
Oh shit! Blood stuff. All over the walls is swimming in it.
Yeah, you know these people will be loving this game. We're thinking it's cool, you know, but. You know, like, if the game was that or the other way around, I would still kind of like the game because I think the concept is awesome. Mm-hmm. It's cool. The fact that you could, you know, put ink on the floor, then go on the ground, go on the walls, and all that shit.
Hide.
Pop up. Shoot that motherfucker. Bomb that motherfucker. Snipe that motherfucker. Rocket launcher that motherfucker. You know what I mean? All of that.
And run away again.
Run away again, yo. I mean, that shit.
I wonder if you could be shot while you're in the ink. Maybe not.
That's a good question.
If you're in one color ink, right? You're in the purple ink. And some orange motherfucker starts shooting your purple ink when you're in it. Like, does that hurt you?
I don't know.
I guess we'll see.
I don't know. Like, to me, that's ink guerrilla warfare right there, man. You know what I mean? That's what that shit is, man. You ducking and dodging and, you know, and inking motherfuckers. Mm-hmm. And it's a cool concept. You know, it's like, people cannot hate on a console like this, man. Like, I don't know what's wrong with you. You need to get that stupid bias out of your ass. You know? The game is a cool concept. And, you know, it's a third-person shooter, which is also great. Mm-hmm. It's going to have online, 8-player online, right? It's 10-player. 8-player online, I believe. And this is a cool thing. You don't even need to win just by killing people. You just win by, you know, claiming territory. Well, there's probably going to be more modes, though. But, yeah, that's going to be the flagship mode, you know, that type of mode. And, and this is cool, like, they're going to have snipers and all, basically all the usuals from any other third-person shooter or first-person shooter. That's cool, you know, I mean, I'm all for the game, and I can't wait for it. You're going to have single player. Miyamoto was saying that the girl, Squid Inkling, is actually the main character of the game.
Hmm.
Even though you could play with a male Inkling.
Oh, shit.
Huh?
Shots fired.
Shots fired, what?
Go making the female character the main character, man.
Yeah. You guys got...
Other companies can't even do that.
You know what I mean? Like, shit, man. Fucking almost exposing everybody.
Mm-hmm. Now let's talk about the last game that we know of in 2015.
That's Zelda. Now, we talked about a little bit last podcast. Well, mostly Joe, our special guest from last podcast. But Tony didn't really give his two cents on the game. So I'm going to let you talk about this game and what you decided about the game. Like, what was your thoughts, reaction of the gameplay footage that they showed?
Man, just seeing like how big it's gonna be. You just see them going on that cliff, and then you just see everything around there. Oh, you see that place? Yeah, you can go there. I was like, god damn, they gotta have another big ass world game. Like, you got Xenoblade Chronicles X, and you got Zelda 2. I was like, god damn, what am I supposed to do? What do you want to do with my life, Nintendo?
But you know what's the interesting thing about that, though? I was hearing Miyamoto explaining that they're trying to design a game where it's like you're doing one task, but this takes you're just playing for like an hour at a time or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Which is insane to me. Is that actually feasibly possible to design a game that's an open world game, but still feel like you're not wasting hours and hours in it?
Hey, if somebody can do it, Nintendo can do it.
I know they could do it because they're the Miyamoto and the team back then. They're the creators of open world. You know, Ocarina of Time was the, you know, the first of its time back in the N64 days. If people don't know their history, you know, people like to take that for granted. But like, yeah, Ocarina of Time was truly the, you know, the first game of its kind. Or at least the game that did it to did it better than anything else prior before. So,
I don't know, man, how it's going to be, because I have a thing about open world games where, you know, when you have a story in them, the sense of urgency is gone, like Arkham City, which that fucking review I did is still fucking getting views and people commenting. I was like, I don't know why.
Really?
God damn, man. Like, every couple days, like, shit, shut up about these fucking games.
Like, people are still mad and, like, passionate about that piece of shit.
I guess.
I mean, not a piece of shit, but I mean, that's impulse right there. I meant to say it's a piece of shit, but yeah. So passionate about that game.
Yeah. That's like, fucking crazy. But the thing I complain about that is, like, you're poisoned, right? In the middle of the game somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
You're poisoned, and you got to go get the antidote. But since it's an open world game, you can go fuck around and do anything you want. How am I playing hours and hours of fucking game time while I'm fucking poisoned? You know what I mean? Like, there should be something there saying, get the fuck on with the story or something, you know? Something. Because this is, like, taking me out. Like, oh, it's such an important, epic story, but I could just go around collecting trophies for 5 hours, right? And then maybe I'll come back to you and do the story. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Like, the story has to be good. There has to be lots of stuff to do. It can't just be me walking to area with nothing in between. There's got to be something in there, like Lego City Undercover. That open world game was like probably that one, and Spider-Man 2 was like the one that was like, yeah.
Yo, you're bringing it back, Spider-Man 2, yo. Oh, man, you see, man. These thoughts have fallen so low, man. Yes. Yo, these thoughts have fallen so low. Like, why can't we get shit like that anymore, man?
Mm-hmm.
That game was a gem, man. I love that game, Spider-Man 2.
Yeah. I would, like, just because you are a Spider-Man, you could just fucking swing around the city and just be happy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, I'm Spider-Man. Swing around, you know? Yeah. And everything felt
and
good.
Then you're falling from, like, you know, like fucking 50 feet in the air and all that shit. You just feel good, and then building. And then at that right part, poosh, swings, you know, the swing.
Exactly.
You know, the web sling, and then like, it's crazy.
But then, like, you got other open world games that's just okay, like, there's nothing around here, and just okay, do whatever you want, right? Like, okay, I kind of want to do things,
you know?
But not like things that are random. I kind of want to do a mission, but not the same fucking missions every fucking time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, in Lego City, just, like, everywhere. Every single area. Every single inch of that fucking game. Oh, you want to build something here? Go build something here.
Go drive something here.
You get a race. You get a time trial. You know what I mean? There's so much shit in that game. And that made the open world, like, feel alive.
Yeah.
Hopefully the Zelda is gonna feel alive.
Alive.
Yeah.
It's alive.
We're playing it so empty and blah 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 blah. Look, it's still early. First of all, second of all, they showed like an enemy stronghold over there, right? With a couple of enemies here and there.
Plus, they're gonna be dungeons, you idiots.
Yeah, that's it.
They didn't even show a dungeon yet, yo. This is the open world they're showing. You know how big this game is? Oh, these people are so stupid. Like, I can't wait for E3 2015 when these dudes get fucking exposed to the 100th power. Nah, fuck that. To the 1,000,000th power. These people are look so damn stupid. Because they always do this shit to themselves. Why do you set yourself up for failure to be look retarded?
Yeah.
You know? Why do you do that shit to yourself? I never like understand it with these people.
That's true.
It's like they create this bullshit. They get that quick buzz, mm-hmm. right? And then they're gonna look like a dumbass down the line.
But that's the thing, though. They don't look back into history, right?
Yeah.
Ocarina of Time, that shit was empty. But like at night, for instance, fucking skeletons would come out of the fucking ground every 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Just You know, just coming
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
At night, that shit was dangerous, boy.
Or that spinning thing coming at you, and what's a P hat? Is that P hat or is it? I forget what it's called.
I forgot what those things are called. Yeah. That's the thing with the freaking blades, yo.
Yeah, they would just appear randomly.
Yo, man. And you know what felt like so cool, man? When you feel like a boss, you're a boy, and you doing backflips like a Jeep. I'm telling you, man. Like, that's like really, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying. You really got to really think about the character Link and the fact that this dude's a kid, and he's doing backflips like a professional. Like, you know what I'm saying? This is what makes you know, like, this dude is no ordinary kid, you know? This man is like a, well, not Capera, but, you know, he's on that level, man. He got that. He got them strong knees, a strong frame. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Doing that shit, man. He got that balance, man. You know, he's doing all that shit, man. And he gets the girl. See that?
Yeah.
And he gets the girl.
It's going to be a good year.
Good year, boy. 2015. A lot of good things in 2015. We got Star Wars in 2015.
Mm.
And that fucking, I'm going to say that teaser trailer didn't did nothing for me. This real talk. That did nothing, man.
Because it showed nothing.
It showed nothing. Mm-hmm. Real talk, man. But whatever. We'll see.
Star Wars.
we'll see when they show it, man. We'll see when they show it.
Mm-hmm.
We got the
Avengers.
We got Avengers. I almost forgot about that. We got that Spectre, that 007, baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got the oh my god, that Austin Martin DB5 DB10, my bad, looks sweet, yo. I can't wait to see what that shit could do, because you know Q is gonna pimp that shit up. You know Q is gonna pimp that shit up, so I can't wait to see what that thing could do. I was kind of like looking at the Bond girls, and I really didn't know if they were hot or not. I couldn't really tell. I don't know if they look jacked, but we'll see when the trailers come out.
Let me just say this.
For
James Bond, I don't know who holds the rights anymore, but for God's sake, make a fucking video game.
Oh my god. Thank you. Like, that's the truth right there. Please. I need my 007 fix back.
I know.
007 fix.
Don't half-ass that shit. Make it properly. Like, what the fuck, man? I don't understand. We're living in a world with no fucking 007 games. The last one came out in 2012. What the fuck?
I know, right?
Makes no damn sense.
Hell, not even Sony. Not even Sony wants to take a handle of that. It's crazy.
Stupid.
It's like, made me wonder if EOM Production even wants to give it to developers anymore. Like, you know, fuck that bullshit, right? You know, it's just amazing. Like, after how Activision treated that shit, they're saying, nah, man, we're done with this shit, man.
Mm. No.
You know?
How you let EA do better than you, fucking assholes?
That's what I'm saying. How?
That's what EA was all right.
Yeah, that was EA. That was when EA was good, though.
Mm.
Then I don't know what happened, man.
That shit makes me sad, man.
They got too greedy.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking start buying up people. And then the developers, when they start buying, they just lost the mojo, man. They didn't give a fuck. Like, oh, fuck it. Whatever.
Yeah.
Just release the game.
Just release it. Yeah. Fuck it. It's broken. Who cares?
Yeah.
Fix it later. Maybe.
Exactly.
Fuck. That makes me sad, man.
I don't know. It's a fucking sad days, man.
Everything or nothing.
Yeah.
I didn't play the N64 ones too much, except for GoldenEye. Like, what's it called? Agent Under Fire. I forget. What is it? What are the other ones called?
The first one on GameCube. On
Nightfire, I mean. Yeah, that's it.
I have it. I played that. Well, I basically played all of them, except that Tomorrow Never Dies one.
That one looked like shit.
Yeah, that one looked kind of like
dodge. I won't lie. I wanted to play it. Even though I never had a PlayStation 1. I wanted to play that one. It's like, oh, you can fucking ski. We ride the car and shit like that.
Yeah, it sounded absolutely. Yeah, at the time, it was pretty cool for James Bond, you know? Like, yeah. That's pretty cool. But, yeah.
No.
Yeah, I played GoldenEye. I played Tomorrow Never Dies. I still have it, man, with the box and everything.
Mm.
Okay? Tomorrow Never Dies. I like that game, though. People don't really like that, you know, don't really like that game too much, but I like that game, though. It's pretty funny, even with multiplayer. Agent on the Fire, mm-hmm. Nightfire, Everything or Nothing, Russia with Love. Mm-hmm. Fucking, even that Quantum Solid game I played, man. Yo, even that shit, man.
What was the other game? Blood Ruby or Bloodstone?
Bloodstone. I think it was Bloodstone. Stone? I never played that one. Never played that one.
You're fucking up.
Yeah, see, Activision was fucking up, man. That's the thing. Like, you know, I like GoldenEye, though, on the Wii. I like that one. But that was pretty cool to see GoldenEye with Daniel Craig. I kind of like how they did that. But, mm-hmm. you know, other than that, yeah, you know, they were fucking up hardcore, man. Like, I would rather have an original story than this GoldenEye remake. Like, why are you doing that?
Yeah.
But it was still pretty cool, though. But, yeah, I guess that's it. Oh yeah, you know. Done for the topic. Now for question time. Oh wait, yeah. No questions. Yeah, I forgot. No questions. Yeah. So there's no questions for this episode, people, because no one submitted a question. Not even one.
They're busy.
It's okay. It's holiday time. You know, you're eating that turkey.
You're tired. Sleep before you do a question.
You know, you have dudes fucking never mind, fuck it. I was gonna say something. It don't matter. But yeah, you know, everybody is busy, whatever, that's understandable. But whatever. Anyway. So don't forget to subscribe, people. Don't forget to like, you know, rate, comment, share. I always like to hear your feedback. Submit more questions for the next podcast.
More questions.
Well, more Amiibo ones?
No, more which equals one.
Okay. Follow us on Twitter, you know, links in the description for that. Let's check the video description and all that good stuff. You know what to do. Follow the instructions. Scroll down it. Look through it one by one. And then you know what to do.
Exactly.
And anything else before we go?
I can't think of anything right now. I got a couple videos in my brain right now that I might make on my channel, so don't worry, there will be video game content.
I don't understand, man, why is that even an issue, man? Like,
yeah.
I mean, you talk about other stuff, that's cool and everything. I like when you talk about other stuff, it's interesting, you know?
Yeah, mix it up, man.
Mix it up, and it's good to know about other industries that people are a fan of that you might not be that into, or like you semi like, you know,
because sometimes it's similar, like some things that the things that they do or the shit that happens is similar to, or it could happen to video games or something, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like it could apply,
yeah,
plus the like for comic books the characters can be in video games and you know what I mean, it's just whatever, keep your minds open, motherfucker. That's all right.
Everybody's gonna like what they're gonna like.
If you don't like it, let me just say this: I'm a bass motherfucker on YouTube. I do what I want to do. So
yeah, exactly.
So I talk about what I want to talk about. If you don't like that, well, you know, that's too bad. But it's not. I'm not getting rid of video games. That's all.
Let me say this too, all the my recent new subscribers. Welcome to KD3D. You know, if you say, I'm going to tell you right now, you might be blocked before you even know it. So, okay, I'm just telling you right now because the reason I'm doing that is for you, okay? Because when I get in the ass, okay, I don't know how to stop, okay? Okay, when I'm grinding my foot in the ass, I don't know how to stop, so I need to block some of you motherfuckers before I make, you know, this start getting to you and start making you motherfuckers cry.
Suicide rate's gonna go higher.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So I need to No, I don't know, because when I get that ass, man, I'm like, boom. Hours and hours in the ass, man, because,
Yeah.
I guess because me, man, I get like, I've been doing this for a long time, people, man, so when I got that stupid ass troll doing his shit, I want to stomp him, stomp him, motherfucker, you know? I get that, I get that thrill, boy. But, anyway, I digress.
Yep.
That's a wrap.
Happy New Year.
Nalisa la vida.